Hello and welcome. I have a very special guest with me to talk about the road ahead for Coca-Cola and Coca-Cola in India specifically. James Quincey, CEO, joins me today. Thank you so much, James. Good morning and welcome to India.
Thank you. It's great to be back.
Wonderful. First thing, your feeling about, or your feelings about that feeling called India, what do you feel about it?
Look, I guess my biggest feeling about India is it's always been, is, and always will be an incredibly vibrant place. It's a huge country with great potential opportunity, and it's just always exciting to be here, to feel the vibe, and to look at all the opportunities that are ahead.
And for, you know, for India as a market for Coca-Cola, as a place for Coca-Cola, give me a sense of that. How important is India for Coca-Cola company? You're the sixth largest market. So how important is India for?
Yeah, I mean, India is very important for us. You mentioned it's now reached the point of being the sixth largest market for us. It's come up the rankings very consistently over the years. In the end, I see it in a relatively simple way. You know, India will become one of the top three markets. The next step is to become number five. So becoming one of the top five will be an incredible achievement, and I think that is within sight. But in the end, the goal will be within the top three markets, and India will be a great future place to continue to do business and grow and be part of the community.
So for that number five and number three, is there a vision that you have or a roadmap? How long could that take?
I think there's no exact timeline. I think what we need to do is go out there and construct the business. But what's important in life is to have a vision of how far you want to get, to have some bold ambition. Yet the road that will need to be taken, you can't see the whole thing from the beginning. Yet we can see and we know what needs to be built. And as long as we follow what the consumer wants and what creates value for our customers, I believe we'll be able to hit number five in the near future on our way to being number three.
I've been following some of what you've been saying about the changes that are happening, the transition that's happening at Coca-Cola. What is this transition, and give us a sense of the roadmap for that?
You know, there's a very important statement being made about the Coca-Cola company. I mean, one of the challenges, one of the great strengths, but one of the challenges for the Coca-Cola company is the brand is also the name of the company. And that sometimes stops people seeing, or even our own employees and systems seeing, that actually in the end the company is bigger than the world's best brand. And I think what this transition is about is really establishing with clarity the journey whereby the brand Coca-Cola remains the heart and the soul of the company, yet the company becomes much, much bigger than that one brand. And it does so by entering and being successful in a whole series of different categories. Again, following the consumer, creating value for our customers, but in the end, building a much broader company. And that's what's behind the idea of Beverages for Life, so that really we can be part of every consumer's total day, whichever beverages they want to drink.
Interestingly, in India, the talk has been around the circular economy in the last few weeks and months. You know, the focus has been linking it to agriculture. Why is Coca-Cola in India making that bold move around the fruit circular economy that is being talked about?
I guess I would offer a couple of thoughts. One is, we as a company, we really believe that for the business to be successful, the country and the community needs to be successful. And part of the transition that India is undergoing is clearly going to be that the agricultural sector needs to become more productive, produce more, the farmers make more money, and yet over time there'll be less people working in agriculture, and they will need jobs in the manufacturing and service sectors. And we will be a very small part of that journey, but we will invest and be a player in that journey. So we will invest, as you said, in the circular economy, in farms, helping them improve their yields, improve their profitability, grow more. We will buy large parts of that, and that will help boost the earnings and the success of the agricultural sector. But it will also help us make drinks, manufacturing, distribution, selling, and create jobs in the manufacturing and service side of the economy that will help the total community move forward.
Mm-hmm. Also, I mean, the other part of the business, which is the sparkling beverages, there's been some kind of a misconception that they may not be safe. What will you tell? Because that the whole issue comes to, you know, it kind of surfaces again and again.
Yeah, look, the people say lots of different things around the world. I think there's something that's really clear, that sparkling beverages absolutely can play a part of your everyday diet, whether they have sugar or they don't have sugar. We've spent time on the safety front, I mean, over our entire 130 years history, making sure we only use the finest and the safest ingredients and work with public health and governments around the world to make sure that that's what we're doing. And so we will always do that because in the end, the first thing that consumers want from any global brand is to know that they're getting the best.
So what keeps you awake at night? You know, and you know, some of these worries, they tend to you travel all around the world. What really keeps you awake at night?
There's a famous quote that has been attributed to Roberto Goizueta that he used to say, "I sleep like a baby. I wake every couple of hours crying." But what do you worry about? Well, I think that what I really worry about, you know, once you strip away the problems of the day, the latest opportunity that we can chase, in the end, the biggest thing that most CEOs worry about is the catastrophic mistake because the culture has gone the wrong direction. We could list a number of companies. Every few years, there's another major instance where the culture of the company has drifted so far away from what's right that they make a mistake that either really damages or even destroys the company. And you can list the sorts of crises that have happened over the last 10 and 20 years, and those companies have disappeared. And so when I think about what really keeps me awake, it's making sure the company's culture stays true to values and that we don't make those catastrophic mistakes. Of course, if you get that culture right, you focus on the opportunities and you build a better business every day.
Mm-hmm. So what is James Quincey outside of work? And also, if maybe two or three words that could describe you?
Two or three words that describe me? Well, I think that's always a very difficult question. Sometimes when people ask for the three words, I say James Robert Quincey, so I can be an individual. What I actually love is doing lots of different things. I like exploring new countries, whether it's India, other parts of Asia, Europe, the Americas. And I love activities, whether it's skiing or hiking or exploring. It's a little harder to do tougher sports as age goes on, but I like doing lots of different things.
And outside of work, how would you describe yourself? Just following that passion, the passion that you possibly bring to work?
Yeah, I like getting involved in things, whatever it is, you know, whether you get deeply into a book or deeply into an activity. I like doing things that are interesting, that are stimulating. And of course, like many other people, I like lying on the sofa sometimes and watching some TV.
Okay, final question. What is your message to the people of India?
I think the message is very simple. This is a fabulous country, as you all know. We're very proud and privileged to be a part of it, to be an invited guest to help build a business here. And we will be a dedicated partner, creating jobs and creating value for the community by serving and providing great drinks for consumers and customers.
And anything you'd like to say to the farmers now that there's so much talk and we spoke about the fruit circular economy? Would you like to say anything to the farmers of India as well?
Yeah, look, I think we'd like to help you build a better business and a better livelihood for yourselves. We can bring global and international innovation and knowledge to make you more effective, greater yields, make more money, and be more successful.
So what is your message for the people of India and people who consume some of the beverages that you make?
Well, I think the message is actually pretty simple. It's hum hai tufani.
Okay, that's super.